So continuous light in photography is very restrictive. It's very limited because the power of continuous lights is just a fraction of that of speed lights or strobes. So, you know, if you're doing anything in a lot of light, outdoors, anything like that, continuous light is just not very useful. And I know there's a big push right now for all these small, tiny continuous lights, and they're really only useful in like low light situations or nighttime situations. They're pretty restrictive. But if you are in a low light situation or a night situation, continuous light is actually very useful because a lot of times your strobes and sometimes even your speed lights is just too much power even on the lowest setting in those low light situations. So I was recently in Louisville for imaging, and it was the last day that we were there, the last night that we were there. We had been there for 4 days already, had did a ton of photo shoots, so I was exhausted. But I wanted to get one last shoot in. Now, this shoot was supposed to have been a natural light shoot. I really wanted to shoot it during the day. The Airbnb that we were staying in had these really big windows. There was a ton of natural light and it was absolutely beautiful. And I will always gravitate towards natty light over off-camera flash every day of the week if the natty light gives me the look that I want. So I really wanted to do this shoot natty light. Now I'd already did a shoot the day before in the same space, natty light. So this might've been universe telling me like, Talk, you need to switch it up. So long story short, the model ended up not getting there until nighttime, completely dark. So natty light was out of the question. So because I was so tired, I was exhausted, I really just wanted to do a shoot that was going to be easy, and natty light would have given me that because I didn't have to worry about, you know, having an off-camera flash with a modifier, moving it every time I want to do a shoot, all of these things. You know, off-camera flash can be restrictive, especially if you're by yourself. Now, of course, I had the guys there, so I probably could have had them hold lights, but they were exhausted too. So it just was going to be easier to do natural light. So when she came and it was dark, you know, I kind of had to figure out what I wanted to do. And so I had recently got this light from Sutefoto, the P230, which is a 230 watt continuous light. I have some other Sutefoto lights. I do like their products. And so I brought it with me to test out, and I did. I thought I was going to go through the whole trip and not have used it, but I was like, this is a perfect opportunity to test this out. Now, the thought process that I had was that, again, I didn't want to have to deal with having an off-camera flash and a modifier that I had to move around. So because it was a 230 watt joint, which is, you know, quite a bit of power, and because it was nighttime, I thought I would use it in a way to where I just illuminate the entire space. So that way I essentially got natural light in a sense. Okay, it wasn't coming through the windows, but I essentially got natty light in a sense, and I didn't have to use flash. And so it really came in handy because it allowed me to just work within the space. I could move around, I could have the model move, I could position her wherever I wanted, I could position myself wherever I wanted, and I had essentially the same quality of light no matter where I placed the model, because I had the light pointed towards the ceiling, so it basically was just flooding the entire space with light. So no matter which direction I was facing, no matter which way the model was facing, there essentially was the same type of light, the same quality of light, and the same amount of light falling on the model. So that made the shoot really easy. Now in hindsight, I do wish that I would have placed it in a way that was a bit more directional, because the lighting was flat. Now, I absolutely love the way the images turned out. Love the way they turned out. When I look at them, of course, as photographers, we always look at our stuff and it's always like, what could we have done different? We could never just chill in the good work that we create. We always got to look at, you know, what we could have done different. So if I could go back and do it again, I probably would have made the light a little bit more directional. So instead of bouncing it off of the ceiling, I really could have bounced it off of a wall. That would have helped it be a bit more directional. Now, the downside of that is that it really would have went against what I was trying to do in terms of keeping things easy and not having to worry about repositioning things. If I was bouncing it off a wall, for example, you know, if I'm sitting here right now, if I bounce it off of this wall, I'm obviously gonna get light coming in this direction, right? So I'm gonna have light on this side of the face. Probably should do it this way because I actually have light coming in this way. But I'm gonna have light on this side of the face, gonna have shadow on this side of the face. So I have a bit more dimension versus if I just bounce it into the ceiling and we just have this light that's coming down. Of course, it's gonna bounce off of the walls, bounce off of the floors. So you kind of just get like this capsule of light. Instead of having that light, I could have had more directional light. But again, the downside of that is that because it's directional, if I turn and face this way, now I got the light hitting this way. So now I got to move that light. So it wouldn't have been as involved and intensive as having an actual off-camera flash with a modifier, but it definitely would have added to having to reposition that. And so although the light was a bit flat, there is still some shadow, but although the light was a bit flat, it worked. And the model was amazing, first of all. I give all credit to the shoot to the model because, as I have mentioned, I was pretty exhausted. I was mentally exhausted. We had did so many photo shoots that I was mentally exhausted. But for whatever reason, I just wanted to get one more shoot in. So the model was awesome. You know, she brought exactly the energy that I was looking for. And I really was like, let's just go for a chill at home vibe. Okay, now to be honest, a big part of me wanting that vibe was because that was just the mood that I was in. I was just like, I just want to chill. I don't want to do anything crazy. I don't want to try to do some elaborate setup. So it really worked, and she brought that chill energy. You know, she had the look. So that paired with, you know, just kind of this evenly lit room lighting, it really just allowed us to kind of do whatever. So I had her, you know, walking back and forth. I had her over here. I had her over there. Had her over there, had her on the couch, you know, all different places within this space. And it just was easy using the light. So although I don't really advocate for using continuous light, I shouldn't say I don't advocate for using continuous light. I definitely try to let people know continuous light is not as useful as I think marketing and social media tries to make it out to be, because you really need a very powerful continuous light to be able to use it in a lot of situations where you normally would shoot. It's not, I won't say it's not often that we shoot in low light or night situations, but a lot of our shoots don't happen in low light or nighttime situations. Of course, if you shoot studio, easy. But a lot of our shoots happen during the day when there isn't necessarily even a lot of light, but most continuous lights are just not that powerful. Of course, if you tap into like the cinematography world, there's lights that are very powerful and also very expensive. So, you know, when you look at continuous light from just a photographer point of view, you're not dropping $2,000 on, you know, an aperture 600 to be able to use during the day. Some do, but, you know, practically wise, you know, we're not really doing that. So continuous lights, they're not that useful, but in situations like this, when you're indoors and you really just want something simple, you want a light source that is just kind of filling the space, this is a great technique to use. Take your continuous light, bounce it into the ceiling, and then now you just kind of have this soft light that's filling the room, and you can just kind of do whatever you want to do. And if you want to add direction to that, you can either bounce it off of a wall, or you could bounce it off of, you know, a V-flat, or any, I mean, you could bounce it off of essentially anything that you want to bounce it off of. So if you don't have a wall, take a V-flat, take a 5-in-1 reflector, you know, take whatever, and you can bounce it off of that to be able to have more direction in your light. So you do have some options there. So it's a great technique, and I would encourage you to try it out the next time you want to do a shoot, you're indoors and you're feeling a little bit lazy. It's the way to go.